money, and thank you so much for the leadership that you've been providing to expose this crisis at our border, to talk about how bad this immigration crisis is that was created by Joe Biden when he opened up America's southern border. And when you see millions of people that have already come across illegally, what we are seeing all across the country, what's making every single community in America a border town, is the illegal drugs, the fentanyl that's coming across the border with the drug cartels taking operational control over our border when Joe Biden gave that away. 100,000 plus deaths of young people last year from fentanyl overdoses and other drugs that are coming across our border illegally. None of this needed to happen. And Republicans have tried over and over again to bring legislation to the floor to secure our southern border, and Democrats want nothing of it. They want an open border. Kamala Harris, who President Biden put in charge of the border, still refuses to go down the border and then acts like she's in denial, goes on TV and says the border's secure. And then, of course, we saw a busload of illegal migrants coming to the Naval Observatory right outside of her house as she's saying the border's secure, and they're all being interviewed saying they came to America illegally because they know the border's wide open under the Biden administration. They created this problem. They don't want to fix it. We will. We're going to continue to push on this House floor to address these problems. Another problem America's facing, maybe the biggest problem that families are facing, is inflation out of control. The cost of everything that families try to buy is higher because of Joe Biden's policies, because of the trillions in spending, because of the radical regulations, and he continues to deny this is a problem. We saw him on 60 Minutes just the other night, acting as if 8.5% is really just 0.2%. because it was 8.3 and it went to 8.5, and he acted like it was just a blip, just a minor little change. And he had to be corrected by the 60 Minutes host and reminded that it's a 40-plus year high of inflation. It's not a minor blip. It's a major problem for families that Joe Biden's created, and he acts like it doesn't even exist. Maybe in his little bubble that he hangs around, the far leftists that talk about nothing but spending and doubling the size of the IRS. To them, that's economic stimulus. But to families, it's one more crippling blow after another that's making it harder for them to buy the things that they need for their lives. Good luck trying to become a first-time home buyer, because under Joe Biden's wild, massive spending spree with Nancy Pelosi, we've seen mortgage rates more than double, over 100% higher cost to get a mortgage if you want to be a first-time home buyer. So now they've even put the American dream, the ability to buy your first house, out of reach for many more Americans because of all their radical policies. So again, we're going to be rolling out our commitment to America this Friday, because we're going to show the country what a Republican majority would do to actually address and confront the problems families are facing that have been created by all of this radical far-left socialism, by Joe Biden, Nancy Pelosi, and all of those other Democrats here in Washington who are voting right down the line, one after another, for these radical policies. There is a better way. We have an answer. We're going to provide solutions. With that, we'll